Welcome. Today we're going to be reviewing the Mazda Miata MX-5. Hoy vamos a estar haciendo el review al Mazda Miata MX-5. If you're in Florida, you have to have a convertible, big, small, whatever is your choice. My choice was this one for now, and we're in the beautiful Miami. Of course, the weather is wonderful, so you gotta have the top down. All right. So if you like the design is actually really, really nice compared to all the other small convertibles. I mean, you have this is like a middle. I guess price you could say convertible that you can get. It's not all the way up there, you know, super expensive, and it's not also very cheap, but I think it's accessible for everybody, which is really cool. So we're gonna be taking it out for a spin. Ooh. So it kind of like, you know, flows with it. So let's take it for a spin and see what the cons and the pros are in Jenny's language. Of course, I am not a car expert, of course, and I think most of us, when we go out to buy cars, at least women, not everybody, you know, we don't like to generalize, but we always just look at the little gadgets inside the car. So that's what I'm going to be doing. You know, what do I look for when I look for a car? And engine wise, if you're looking for that kind of review, Google something else. It's not going to happen. Bueno, así que vamos a hacer un pequeño review al Mazda Miata MX-5. Le damos un poquito del estilo que tiene aquí con por afuera. Muchos de los convertibles, por supuesto, que tienen de super deportivos son muy caros. Por lo tanto, este me encanta porque no solamente está en la mitad del precio, o sea, es accesible para todo el mundo, no es ni muy barato ni muy caro. Por lo tanto, vamos a estar llevándolo por un spin, como se dice en inglés. Y bueno, yo soy mujer, o sea, de que si estás buscando ese tipo de review, donde estás buscando específicamente algo del motor o algo, no miren este review porque no va a ser así. Obviamente, al ser mujer no hay que generalizar, pero no conozco mucho de autos. Por lo tanto, voy a ser honesta y les voy a dar el estilo Jenny de review, a mi estilo, lo que busco yo cuando voy a comprar un auto. Adentro, los chiches, los garabatos, todo eso. Así que bueno, bienvenidos y vamos a hacer el test. Alright guys, so we're inside. First thing that I look at least, all the design and everything. I love the stitching that's going on right here. You have a little like burgundy stitching. The steering wheel is nice, and you have to hear it when it starts. Very important. Ready? Vamos a ver, muy lindo toda la terminación que tiene. Tiene como una terminación medio rojiza, lo cual, bueno, un poquito femenino, pero creo que pueden escoger el color que ustedes quieran. A little bit feminine, I have to say, but I'm sure that they have many other styles that you can get. Actually, before I started, so we have no compartment here in the front. No tenemos compartimiento aquí al frente. So the only compartment that we have, this is a weekend car, you have to know this. This is un auto de fin de semana. We have this little thing right here, maybe for, I don't know, how about your keys? Vamos a poner las llaves aquí. El único que entra is probably the only thing that fits in there. And then you have this little compartment here, which, instead of bringing a purse, you know, let's just bring one of those, you know, small wallets. And then you have the Mazda book, which I'm sure you're not going to take anywhere, so you could take that out and fit something bigger. Creo que es un auto tipo fin de semana, ¿no? O sea, tampoco vas a ir de vacaciones con esto, a no ser que estés solo. So if you're, you know, single, or it's just two of you, no kids, it's a perfect weekend getaway car. And of course, you gotta have that SUV or that van if you have kids. But hey, you know, what about date night? Now, date night, I realized one thing, and that's a big con that I got out of this car, which is the fact that my husband's very tall, so he doesn't fit in here. When he fits, his knees are literally just hitting the dashboard, so he has to either drive. It's good for him to drive, but not to be in the passenger seat, which is, you know, bad. So I just get to go out for myself, by myself. So it's kind of like, I think that they made it for, like, they didn't make it for tall people and they didn't make it for short people, kind of like people in between. So I'm a little, you know, I'm tiny, so I realized that, okay, this is actually not bad. You have a good view right here, but sometimes, you know, it's good to have a little bit more of an extra. Actually, today, for some reason, it's good, but after I started driving for a while, I feel like I need to lift up for some reason. So the seat, you can, you know, you have your regular, you know, seat adjustment and everything, but you don't have the one that actually pulls the seat up a little bit more. So, you know, you don't want to be right in the border of the steering wheel trying to look up. So we can adjust this, of course. Podemos ajustar el manubrio. Let's see, a little bit lower. Or this is probably not the best thing that you're going to look for if you're buying a car. But I have my backup right here, which is, you know, one of these. So I've had to use this recently, you know, when I feel like I'm like sinking in or something, because it's really low. So just kind of like again, like, this is not something that you would want to do, but Mazda, you know, you need to do the option to go ahead and lift the seat up a little bit, because for us tiny people, we need to be up a little more to have a better view. Bueno, para la gente chica, pues yo soy pequeña, así que necesito un poquito más de visor, o sea, necesito poner un cojín o algo, porque de lo contrario quedo un poquito baja. Vamos a intentarlo sin, igual. Anyway, let's try it without it, because of course, the whole idea is to get the feel of it just as it is, nothing adjusted, nothing added. Another thing, the screen, let's turn it on. Let's, you guys, you have to listen to it when it turns on. It's actually, it's very, very sporty. So even for girls, I love the sound of it. You know, I know we're not usually a big, big fan of sound when it comes to cars. At least I'm not. I'm like, it's too loud. But this is just music to your ears. Vamos a escuchar cuando empieza porque es música a los oídos. See, soft, not too loud, not too low. Let's put our seatbelt on. Distractions may cause accidents. Do not operate while driving. Yes, we are distracted filming, but we are in a very low traffic area, so it's fine. So, all right, so let's go ahead and check out the little gadgets that we have. Actually, that goes the other way. The cool thing that I found about this car is that, first of all, your speakers are actually right here for when you, you know, connect your phone to your Bluetooth. And the only cons that I've got is that people that I've called, they've said, where are you? You sound like you're inside of a can. A tin can. And I'm like, so I don't know if it's, you know, dependent on the phone who receives it or if it's the car. I'm sure, you know, everybody will have a different experience in that. But I do love this because you hear it right really, really close. So no matter if you're in an area with a lot of sound, you're still going to have a good sound right here and be able to hear whoever you're calling really good. Bueno, lo chévere, algo que me encantó es el tema de los speakers. Para cuando estás hablando por teléfono, los tienes aquí. Vamos a mostrar aquí el asiento. De este lado también. Es fantástico porque así haya mucho ruido alrededor, vas a tener un sonido espectacular. Ahora, lamentablemente a la gente que he llamado me ha dicho, ¿dónde estás metida? Suena como si estuvieras dentro de una lata. O sea, de que siempre hay cosas positivas y hay cosas negativas. Como todo auto, nada es perfecto. Y lo que puede ser bueno para mí, por ahí es malo para ustedes. Viceversa. Now, of course, you know, the things that I can see as a pro can be a con for you. The things that I can see as a con can be a pro for you. So, this is, let's keep our mind open. This is just, you know, giving you the point of view and see how we like it. This is a 2016 version, Mazda Miata MX-5. And let's see. Okay, this is pretty cool. You can actually take this out. I thought I broke it when I did that. But no, so I'm guessing you can buy more of them and you can have an extra one here. Just put it there or put it here. Eso está bueno. Yo pensé que cuando lo había sacado lo había roto. I'm like, oops, broke it, and then I realized, no, you can put it back on. No se rompe, lo pueden volver a poner simplemente así. Actually, yeah, that's it. Well, let's take it for a spin. Vamos a llevarlo por un spin, por una vuelta. Vamos a llevarlo a dar una vuelta y a ver qué onda. También el techo, no terminamos todavía. Ya volvemos. So we'll be right back, and you guys stay with me. Come on. Thing, of course, the first thing you notice, just like any sports car, is the fact that it's so low to the ground that no matter how fast you're going, you're always gonna think or feel like you're going a little bit faster. So if you just like took off and maybe we're going 20 miles an hour, it's gonna feel like you're going 30. If you're going 40, it feels like you're going 50 or 60. I mean, it's pretty fast. The feeling that you get, at least, that you're going. And then you look down and it's like, oh, I'm not even going that fast. So, I think that's pretty cool. Lo chévere de los sports cars es que, bueno, como estamos tan bajito al piso, sentís que vas rápido, así vayas despacio. Por lo tanto, estamos yendo recién ahora a 15 millas por hora. Sin embargo, parece mucho más. Si estás arrancando y llegas a 40, parece que estás yendo como a 50 o a 60. Tenemos un montón de chiches, por supuesto, electrónicamente, ¿no? El 2016 todo se viene con unos cambios y más adelante también. Pero bueno, uno de los sensores que tenemos es para doblar, por ejemplo. It has a sensor that beeps and tells you, hey, you know what, your turn signal's still on, you need to shut it off. It kind of complains, you know? Se empieza a quejar. Si tenés la señal de giro y te olvidas de apagarla, se queja diciéndote, ¿sabes qué? Me tenés que apagar, te olvidaste de mí. Another thing, when I sat the first time in this car, the heaters of the seat were on. So it's pretty strong, and that's pretty cool. I mean, if you're living in a place where it's really cold, but here in Florida, you don't need it. So you have it for both seats. Tenés los dos asientos con calentamiento. Yo cuando me senté al principio, I sat down and I'm like, why is my butt so warm? And then I realized, oh, that's on. So you have like a, you have three ways. It's, you know, a minimum, a medium, and the high. That really just burns your butt. But you know, being in Florida, how come nobody has invented yet, you know, the same for the heat, but an AC wise, you know, because you leave these leather seats out in the sun. I know it might seem like a silly idea, but who knows? Maybe somebody will pick it up. You leave the car in the sun, and the leather seats get really, really hot, believe it or not. So when you go to sit, it burns you, especially if you're wearing shorts. So it wouldn't be a bad idea to also add, hey, you know, an AC kind of option to it, so then you can, you know, cool the car while you're getting there, or just turn the AC on. But bueno, yo digo, si ya han hecho la opción de tener el... There's a hole in the front. Si ya han hecho la opción de tener calefacción, digamos, para el asiento, cuando uno se sienta, para las personas que vienen en el frío, ¿por qué no también poner algo de frío? O sea, yo vivo en la Florida, o sea, que acá vos dejas el auto afuera con un poco de sol, y cuando te vas a sentar te quemas el culiculi. Así que más cuando tenés shorts puestos, te quemas también las piernas. Pero bueno, tenés que esperar un rato a que se enfríe el auto y todo, así que sería una buena idea, solo lo estoy tirando ahí. Let's see, we have the sports option, but before we get to that, I want to go over a little bit of the gadgets. So we have also the sensor. It went off already, but if you leave the sign on for too long, if you're going straight, it'll turn on. You also have another sensor for when a car is next to you. You know, that I think comes with most of the 2016 cars nowadays, which is, you know, in both sides, it tells you if there's a car next to you there or here, meaning, you know, warning you that, hey, you shouldn't turn now. So that's pretty cool. I was a little bit disappointed that we don't have a backup camera, but, you know, I think that it's also optional. You know, if you want a backup camera, you just pretty much go ask for the feature and you're good. If you're used to using the backup camera like I am, you know, you'll miss it if you don't have it. Para los que les gusta ir en automático, este es automático. Para los que les gusta ir en manual, tienen la opción de ponerlo manual. Vamos a ponerlo manual ahí. We're going to put it on manual, all right? I have not yet learned how to drive a stick shift. So I know, disappointment for some of you. But I'll learn, don't worry. Next car we do, I'll get a stick shift. But this has an option. You know, you could change the gears here. You know, more, you know, a gear up. There you go. Oh, no outlet again. Or down. So it's really up to you. If you want to use it and really feel the changes in gear, you can go ahead and put it in manual mode. Not a lot of people like it. You know, they say it's not the same. So, all right, go ahead and get a stick shift. I got a manual for now because it's a little bit easier. And you don't have to think too much, you know, even though I know most people that drive it are like, oh, it's your subconscious just acts by itself, you know. Bueno, otra de las cositas, a ver, vamos viendo. Tenemos también el sensor que te avisa si hay un auto al costado. Another really, really cool feature that I was like, oh, that's cool, is the windshield wipers. So it started raining the other day for the boat show. Yes, Miami has a beautiful weather, but it does rain a lot. So, when it rains up to the point that you're getting you know, problems with your visibility, it's gonna go off automatic. If you have it put on automatic, you can switch it up to manual. I don't see the point of why you would do that, but it's pretty neat. So it goes by itself. If it's too hard, you know, the rain's too hard, it goes faster. If it's slow, it'll go slower. So you know, it thinks before you act, so that's pretty cool. Tenemos la computadora que piensa por sí sola sin que nosotros la pongamos a actuar. Cuando empieza a llover, si empieza, no cuando está muy poquitito lloviendo, pero si empieza a llover fuerte, el automático tiene un automático para el parabrisas que se prende solo, lo cual me pareció chiche bombón, super chévere. All right, so let's put it in sports mode. Oh, we are in sports mode. Not bad of accelerating there, if you ask me. That was pretty neat. You can answer a call, hang up, just like any other car, pretty much. The volume, go up, go down. Now, another thing that I want to point out is the sense that you can pretty much, you know, put the roof up or down as you're driving, which I obviously don't recommend, but, you know, I have a convertible where it's, everything's automatic. This was, I thought, a con, you know. I'm like, oh, you know, it's so much easier when you get to the car and you just press the button and, you know, it opens by itself or it closes by itself. But you have to have the car totally stopped to do that, obviously. So let's say that you have your convertible down and you're in Miami, and normally, like it always happens, it starts drizzling out of nowhere because you have a cloud or something. It's supposed to actually rain in exactly 15 minutes. Let's see if it happens. But not only that's gonna go off automatic, but you also have the option of just, you know, pulling up here, and just like that, you have your roof on, so it can rain, you know, storm, whatever it wants to do, and you will be safe and sound. You still won't feel the rain though. I mean, it is a pretty small car, so if you go in like a 95 or something, you're not gonna feel much of the rain on you, so don't worry about that. No van a sentir tanta lluvia igual si están en la autopista, por ejemplo, y empieza a llover, porque obviamente es un auto muy pequeño, entonces la lluvia sigue de largo. So the rain pretty much just, you know, keeps going. And to open it, you press here, and you do have to kind of like push it. There you go. See how you have to kind of do it a little bit stronger when it's going down, a little bit more muscle work there. Let me see if I'm forgetting something. So we got the seats, we got all the options for there, we have all the gadgets. Okay, so another cool thing is, don't touch the screen, guys. Also, one of the first things I did was, oh, it's a touch screen. Yeah, you always have a little bit of, you know, grease in your hands, so you want to make sure that you only use it from here, which is actually more comfortable. So just go ahead with the home, you know, put the music settings, navigation, entertainment, whatever you want. Don't be looking at the screen if you're driving, of course. I'm going slow, so. But that's pretty cool. You have the mute button and the volume. See, so, and that's it, you guys. So I think that's the drive. I am quite surprised how soft and smooth it is, being that we're so low to the ground. So I would definitely give it an A+ for the smoothness of the car. Me encanta la, algo que sí es muy positivo es, estamos muy bajitos en el piso, sin embargo se siente extremadamente suave, se siente relajado, o sea, no sentís ese duro que normalmente sentís en un auto de deportivo. And the steering wheel, y el, it's really, really soft. I know it might be silly that I'm doing this, but you know, some cars have really, really strong steering wheels, and like I've tested some cars that are like, what were they thinking when they did this? And it's like you finish driving the car and it's like, you know, your shoulders hurt. So this is actually pretty smooth. As you can see there, the turning is really easy, piece of cake, and that's it. So I think this concludes our test drive for the Mazda Miata 2016 MX-5. I think you guys did a great job. Weekend car, you know, affordable, I think, for everybody. And it's nice, you know, it has that luxury, I guess, that you're looking for in a small convertible. So we'll see you guys next time. Don't forget, stay tuned for all the rest of our videos. And hope you like my hair, you know, with the wind. Con el pelo todo desprolijo con el tema del viento. Pero bueno, espero que les haya gustado, por lo menos una, un punto de vista de mujer, podríamos decir. I guess you got a little bit of a girly point of view when it comes to cars. The engine, I don't know anything about engines. It looks nice and it feels good. El motor se siente espectacular. No sé nada de motores, pero se ve muy lindo y se siente espectacular. Así que bueno, espero de que les haya gustado y nos vemos en la próxima. Quédense aquí en Miami TV. Un besito. Bye, guys. Have a good one.